weeks into a global lockdown, which has left many unable to leave the confines of their homes. And hence, the concept of shooting and producing an ad campaign anywhere in the world now feels alien. Despite these challenges and many obstacles, our creatives continue to shine and they continue to tell stories that inspire. And one such creative I have with us today is Titus Uputru, the National Creative Director of Dentsu One and the Creative Head of Taproot Dentsu. He spent over 25 years in Indian advertising, and he's won not just national but many international awards. His work for the Afghan Telecom also won the interest of the White House, where it was exhibited. So it's such an honor to have you with us, Titus.
Thank you so much, Nazba. I'm very glad to be here too, talking to you.
So I'll start by speaking to you about how the overall creative concepting has changed after the lockdown for the ad world while working from home. Is creativity far closer to home now?
So actually, the way typically we work, within an advertising agency or a brand communication framework is, we usually get a brief by a client at the client's office sometimes, or we internally discuss with the planning and account management teams. And we start off with the briefing sessions, and when we gather, we usually gather in a physical room, and everyone comes in, we find chairs for everybody. We order some rounds of chai and coffee. We start with a few laughs, and it's Munir, my office boy, who keeps bringing us chai and coffee. So after these rounds of nice pleasantries and laughs, we deep dive into the objectives, and the challenges by the brand or the company. And then once the briefing happens, once we get the inspiration, sometimes we revisit the brief and, sit again. Once the inspiration happens, the creative folks usually, they tend to fly.
Right.
And, the flight of imagination happens. And typically, when in my office, when I sit with my team members, when the brief happens, I tell them, ki, go disappear somewhere. Don't sit on your seat, because usually there's a deadline or there's an artwork that needs to be signed. Of course, those are important things. But when you are sitting and thinking and somebody comes and disturbs you every 2 minutes, it just becomes a hindrance, right. Because you are lost in a thought and suddenly somebody is bringing you back. So I tell them, go, just disappear into some room, some conference room, or go downstairs to a coffee shop, and just come back with some ideas, sit with yourselves or with your team members. So, and I feel like when we are locked down like this in the confines of our home, at least one thing is not happening is somebody is over the shoulder asking you, what happened to this, You are able to shut down yourself, certain things, if you want to really disappear into the, the world of creativity or, the world of cracking. And if you see ideas, they don't really are designated to occur within the confines of an office. So typically for creative people, the ideas occur anytime, because your mind keeps working. It's not like you're only sitting in front of a paper and a machine and a pen, and then that's when the mind works. You the seeds have come in, they have been sowed into your brain. And when you're driving or when you're, into a shower or, when you're about to sleep, or maybe when you're in a coffee shop, ideas occur.
Right.
And typical practice is you take down the ideas, because the moment they come, sometimes you forget. So you want to take them down on a tissue paper or even on your notes file in the mobile phone, etc. So in this lockdown period, I think, all these video calls have enabled us to congregate together anyway. The planning, account management and creative folks come together and they jam and they discuss, etc. But the creative process itself, the creative process of thinking, I think it's more peaceful because you are able to confine yourself. You're able to lock yourself into some corner, some terrace, some garden, some backyard. you know, and you're just thinking, you know, and thinking of the ideas. So it's not such a bad place, actually.
Right. So I also want to speak to you about your beautiful, beautiful work for Honda created amidst lockdown. So what was the starting point of that, and what was Honda's brief to you?
Thank you so much. I'm glad you liked it. Actually, Honda always has been known for its wing mark, which is one of its iconic symbols, you know. So it looks like a wing, the brand logo. So back in 2012, I think that was that year, when we did this film called Dekho Dekhe Ye Zamana, Panchi Uda Jai Re. You know, and that film was about the skydivers who created the logo in the sky. And Akshay Kumar says, Jab zameen se paav ud jate hai, to pankh apne aap lag jate hai. So it was this aspect about how I, when I take off my feet off ground, and that's what you do typically when you are on a two-wheeler, right? Because your feet are not on ground. So, and that's when the flight happened. So the wing mark was really integral to the brand. And when this lockdown happened, you know, and we were thinking about all these motorcyclists, you know, and if you see the two-wheeler experience is all almost naked, like you are out in the open, unlike a car which has a shield. There is nothing. You experience the sun, you experience the wind, the raindrops. It's such an outdoor experience. So all these bikers, you know, they are now told to chup baitho ke ghar baitho. So we said, like, you know, it must be so stifling for them, you know, that, you know, you can't go out and you can't just, you know, because inke pair ghar pe tikte nahi hai. So we thought we should do this film where, you know, we can tell them that there is a time for everything. And currently the time is to rest your wings, you know, and that's how the idea came about. And that was the film.
So tell us about the challenges between idea and execution, and how many days did it take to pull it off from brief to execution?
So when the idea occurred, you know, like I wrote down the narrative itself, the voiceover, that how, you know, as birds, you know, like you are, you know, you're supposed to stay at home because there's a time to rest your wings, you know, even though you want to just go about and fly. So the video, when typically when we get a brief, you know, or when we want to make a video, we call up a production house or a director, and then we have long chats on the vision of the film, on how to go about this, making this film. Then we have pre-production meetings, you know, extensive conversations with the client even. We evaluate cost, costume, location, you know, we seek location permissions, you know, then we of course go into shooting. Then we do music composition with Lovely. And I really love those sessions, you know, sitting with music directors. And one of the loveliest experience was sitting with Vishal Bhardwaj, where he was composing a track for my film on harmonium. So that kind of luxury we don't have now because the film industry was shut. So I was thinking, like, how to execute this. So I have a little bit of experience in terms of making films. Like, I directed a few films myself. So I thought, let me just do it, you know, like, how, let me just give it a shot. So what we did was we engaged with people who, you know, love the brand Honda, you know, the two-wheeler, the guys who have motorcycles, Honda motorcycles or Honda Activa or scooters, you know, and we thought, you know, we can talk to them, we engage them. So we found them professing love for the brand on Instagram. So we spoke to young Instagrammers and they were willing to share their beautiful photographs, you know, for this film. And I edited the whole sequence myself. And once we had that, then PP Bajaj, who's an acclaimed voiceover artist, I requested him, saying that, can you lend your voice for this video? And he loved the script and he said, sure. And he recorded it from his own home. And he sent us a few samples, one of which we picked. And then the sound engineering was done by Melvin in Bombay. He was also working out of home. And he was very kind and very patient, you know, to keep revising, you know, the mix as per the need of the hour. And the music, of course, I picked it from a library. So it all came together very well and beautifully. And I thought the sound design and even the pictures, each of them were very beautiful, very soulful. So it was completely a user-generated content piece, you know. if you ask me, and I'm really grateful to all these Instagrammers who have just given those photographs, you know, just to be featured in this ad. I think also because they love the brand, not because I, you know, we ask them or we engage them, but I think they love the brand and they wanted to really put something forward at this time.
Right.
In terms of the duration, you know, when I put together the video, it typically took me about 4 or 5 days, not more than that. But then there were changes which we did thereafter that took some time.
Right. Super. So, you know, team chemistry is considered a very, very important part of the entire creative process. So while working from home, does it go for a toss? And, you know, with so much video fatigue, with your team being, you know, homebound, and, you know, a lot of dreadful news affecting us, how do you foster that creativity?
Well, I can speak for myself and all my teams is like, I don't watch news. Okay, and of course, in this lockdown, unfortunately, newspapers have been shut down. So one doesn't get into that morning ritual. Television and, you know, internet news, we don't watch. Once in 2 weeks, possibly one switches on and checks out what's going on. Most of the news anyway comes to you on your social feed, on your WhatsApp. And, you know, if there is something urgent, people call up, you know. So we are not really worried about it. You know, of course, I have an aunt who said that there is so much news out there and it is so depressing. So I told my aunt, just don't switch off. You know, what's the point? Because these are not under your control. The right. Forest fires, the locust attacks, and the cyclones, or even this COVID virus, these are not under your control. So what can you do about it except keep listening that how many, of course, it is important to know that what is going on in terms of the virus attacks and how one must prevent oneself, and also to know all these warriors who are continuously working, you know, about them. But beyond that, you can't do anything. So it's better to shut the news and in fact pray to God and seek his mercy and grace to have mercy on this planet Earth and redeem us from this problems. So what we do focus, and I kept telling my team, is let's focus on the work at hand. Let's get inspired by creative pieces of work that we must constantly view to get inspired. And also focus on family. This is a time when we have the opportunity of having a meal with the family, a lunch, you know, because usually you are outside, either you are on road or you are with the teams outside. But this is a time when you can grab a beautiful lunch with the family. And I must tell you, one of the things is like when my kids were growing up, you know, they were really young. I used to think, you know, oh my God, I'm really missing what is happening during the day, because I'm gone practically the whole day and I don't have that information of what are these toddlers doing and how are they growing up? How are they, what are they doing? Beautiful things, the wonder years they're called. So while they're grown up a little bit now, I'm fortunate and grateful that I can grab a lunch and, you know, maybe, you know, after a quick lunch, we grab a game of caroms or, you know, Monopoly. So it's nice, those moments, you know. So I tell my team to focus on these things, focus on the positive aspects. We are grateful to God that we are all safe and sound and, you know, like not fallen prey to this virus. So far, so good. So let's focus on the positives, and also work is keeping us occupied. There is so much work. It's not like the work has come down.
Right.
And we are all occupied. And specifically because there is no time to like pick up your laptop and your bag and walk out of the office. It's always, you know, you are sort of occupied. But of course, within that whole aspect, we are trying to make sense of it and, you know, trying to follow a bit of a, you know, regime and schedule, you know, so that we don't go really mental.
Right. So speaking about the positives, this entire situation has brought a great deal of upheaval in the way we work and all that. So where do you see the green shoots of opportunity for the ad world in this?
I think the silver lining, you know, in all of this is, if there is one, which is, I think at least for creative agencies, the traditional creative agencies, it is the fact, you know, I'll give you an example. Like, for example, if I was, and we were, you know, trying to get into the digital world, you know, digital work, you know, and maybe there were lifeguards and we were swimming in a pool before lockdown. After lockdown, we are just thrown into the deep waters, into this gigantic ocean of World Wide Web. And most brands and everybody is just doing work on digital because that's where everyone is queued on to right now. So we are all there and it's amazing, you know, it's amazing experience because, you know, not that we were not doing digital work earlier. We were doing a lot of video content, but right now we are doing things like lead generation. We are doing enhancement of social engagement, you know, content creation and so many other things, you know, like different models of digital, you know, how to engage and how to crack things, you know. So I think it's beautiful experience. It's new freedom that one is enjoying. And I think it's a great time in that sense, you know. So right. I think that is where the curve is, you know, moving completely onto digital world rather than, you know, crack a TVC and then something like an outdoor or a print and then go into digital. The curve has already moved to digital before lockdown, but this is like into the deep. Right. And I always had this dream that, you know, I want to swim in the ocean, you know, literally. Wow. So this is, at least is giving me a metaphorical experience.
Beautiful. So, you know, we've almost reached the peak of pandemic advertising. I see so many ads. In the starting, when it all started off, it was very nice. It was very assuring. And, you know, I was happy that brands are being part of the conversation. But now I see ads and most ads are getting lost in this sea of sameness. So, you know, what is your advice to brands and to creatives now? You know, when they navigate this landscape, how do they decide what to say and how much to say?
So, of course,
because there's a fatigue building in, right?
Sorry, say that again.
Because there's like a fatigue building in. There's so much of coronavirus advertising.
Sure, sure, sure. So, of course, when this lockdown took us, you know, all by surprise, right? We were not waiting for it, or we didn't know that it was an event like this in the very first quarter of the year. So of course, when it took us all by surprise, and I think when brands and every one of us were locked, you know, in, I think it was important to reach out to consumers via brands, you know, to assure them, to you know, to know the, to tell them that we are there, we are listening, and we care as brands, you know. And therefore I think a lot of brands came out with the kind of advertising that we've all seen. But right now, if this is a new normal that is continuing, of course, a lot of offices have opened and people are, you know, encouraged to do social distancing or wearing masks, you know, and how to wear masks. So there are new conversations. And also, I think in the now, of course, we've gone through that phase and it's fair, you know, it's fair enough for brands to do all of that, what they did. I think right. It was very important. It was not just a knee-jerk reaction. But right now, of course, I think there are new ways, new conversations that one must do. Like, for example, if I'm at home, then how can I engage with a brand? How can I buy a brand? How can I, you know new aspects of the brand, because I'm not going into a brick and mortar experience, you know, of a certain brand, for instance. So those are the aspects. How can I, you know, engage with a brand? And new conversations, and I think new conversations will emerge out of this. Although the new Nike film, Nike had done two films. The first film was right about the empty stadiums and every empty basketball courts and all. And now recently what they have done is that, you know, the last bit that you've got, that you give it, you know, and that is so motivational and emotional still. And you don't feel like, okay, man, enough of it. You know, tell me something new.
Right.
It is inspiring everybody and people are, you know, sharing it, those of us who are not even in the business, people are sharing it, and it's just few days back, right? So I just feel like, of course, there's new ways to engage and new insights and new conversations, and one is looking forward to it.
Right. Thank you so much for your time. The entire conversation was not just insightful, but very, very positive. So thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you so much, Ms. Ba. I'm glad you enjoyed. I also enjoyed visiting the last few days, few months, and also, you know, my growing up with my children, etc.